Greetings, cyberdogs and citizens of the internet, and welcome back to episode 15 of this Let's Play Modded Minecraft Survival Stories 3 series with me, ReNDoG. In the previous episode, we were working on upgrading our Meteor Man cave into a technological laboratory of awesomeness, and we did a little bit of work on the entrance as well as some of the rooms around here, and things are looking freaking awesome. In this episode, my friends, we are going to do a little bit more work around here, and we are going to be installing the entrance docking system of the laboratory. Basically, some sort of sweet-ass sliding door action, an airlock, if you will. Difficult to explain, but you guys will see exactly what I'm talking about, man. Sit back and relax. I hope you got something tasty to freaking crunch on and sip on and all of that sweet jazz. I got myself some H2O. Give me a second. Drinking out of a freaking janky ass plastic bottle, man. But hey, I have literally just got back from work about 5 minutes ago, guys. I haven't eaten. I haven't even gone to relieve myself in the bathroom. I literally came home, turned my computer on, and fired up this episode because I've just been thinking about a modded Minecraft the entire freaking day. I had an all-day workshop at my job where we were basically just sitting in a workshop with like 20 other people for the entire day, and all I could think about was this series and all of the work that we have done around here and how awesome this place is starting to look, man. And as soon as I got home, I decided, you know what, I'm gonna play myself a little bit of Minecraft with the CyberDogs. Now, I have been pretty busy off camera since we were last together. I've gone on a little bit of a mining mission, collected myself up about 30 levels or so, which is awesome. Just gonna deposit them into this tank over here. And the reason that I did that was because I wanted to go and get a few more ores, a little bit more iron, a little bit more copper and whatnot, and I have stocked up the laboratory with a whole bunch of jazz. All of this stuff has just finished pulverizing, actually, so that is pretty awesome. And the reason is because my pickaxe is about to freaking die. I think I've thrown it away somewhere around here. Actually, I think I put it into this golden bag of holding. So which one is it? I think it was. Oh, dang it. Oh, I killed it already, I think. Yeah, I killed it already. I wanted to make for myself, actually, a brand new pickaxe. Because, yeah, I have been going through pickaxes like nobody's business. So you know what? I'm going to collect myself up all of these levels. Going to enchant ourselves a brand new diamond pickaxe for today's episode. Hopefully get something sweet out of the enchant. And yeah, guys, I'm super pumped about today's episode because I've been trying to figure out a clever way to create an airlock entrance into our laboratory over here. And of course, what we are trying to achieve right now is an airtight, sterile laboratory, right? That's the build that we are going for. Basically, for those of you guys who are with me for the first Feed the Beast series, we are remaking the Cyber Labs, essentially, but remaking a brand new version of the Cyber Labs that are even more awesome. By the way, picked up some Dulux cheeseburgers on my last adventure, so that is epic, man. Check out that cheeseburger, doing some business. But we just made ourselves a brand new diamond pickaxe, so let's see if we can get ourselves a decent little enchant over here. Come on, baby, kapayam! Unbreaking 3, efficiency 3, silk touch 1. You know what? I will take that. That is a pretty beautiful enchant, if I do say so myself. Now, I have filled my other golden bag of holding, this one, full of all of the laboratory blocks that we are using, some sticky pistons, carpenter's blocks, and whatnot. Just trying to get a little bit more organized in the series. I want to thank all of you guys for the amazing support that you gave me in the previous episode. Wow! The previous episode got more views than any of the other episodes so far in the series, and I think it's because you guys were really loving this entrance that we worked on in the previous episode. And I gotta say, man, I'm with you. It is just absolutely beautiful. And as you can see, I've already started with the foundations of the sliding door using some sticky pistons. Essentially, I want these sticky pistons to go when we come in and come out. Best way to describe it is with sound effects, am I right? So yeah, I kind of want to walk up here for this to go and then walk in here. It'll close behind us, and then there'll be another door over here somewhere, creating an airlock, right? We never want any of the outside air to actually get into the laboratory. Well, that's the plan anyway. Now, I'm super pumped, and one of the reasons why I wanted to start recording right away, guys, because I am super pumped to show you the awesomeness of this ramp that I have been working on. on, been spending a lot of time trying to figure out these chisel blocks. And you know what? I want to thank all of you CyberDogs who have been giving me some excellent advice on the good old chisel mod. You guys are really helping me out a lot with your comments. And I just want to encourage all of you guys who are perhaps pros at chisel to help me out, man. Help me make these this Cyber Labs as awesome as possible. And you guys have been helping me out a lot with these wedges, explaining to me how they work and how we can create actually amazing contours using these wedges. And yeah, it took me about, I don't know, it must have taken about 40 minutes or so to get this configuration right. But using these wedge chisel blocks, these ones, these carpenter's wedge slopes, you guys can see that I have created essentially an amazing slope. I mean, I just think it's, I mean, who needs stairs, right? Look at this, man. Essentially what we're doing here is using these wedges to create this slope, both on the ground level and on the roof level, which gives this absolutely amazing effect. And then we also continue on the slopage that we have on the horizontal here, going up the diagonal. And if that ain't an awesome slope, guys, I don't know what is. And I want to make the whole of the laboratory look like this. I want all of the tunnels and whatnot to share this design, because I think it's, oh man, it is absolutely gorgeous. I got to get it all filled in though with some carpenter's blocks. So let me get that done for now. It kind of makes some pretty weird textures actually. Now that I look at it like this, look at that, man. That is kind of ugly. Yeah, that's kind of tricky. You see, there is so much to the carpenter's mod. It's actually quite crazy. So many little nuances and stuff that you guys know off the top of your heads, especially you guys who have been doing this for a long ass time. But for noobs like me, man, this is all brand new territory, trying to figure out basically the mechanics of these blocks, exactly how they work, exactly how the textures are laid down. But I'm learning slowly but surely. I mean, this looks absolutely janktastic, doesn't it? And we kind of messed this one up, unfortunately. Let's see if we can actually fix it. Let's get the hammer out. So this will kind of show you guys exactly how much work it takes to do this. You got to find the right little slot. No, that's not the one. I think it's actually, yeah, there we go. Beautiful. And then let's get that textured up. But yeah, as you can see, these particular blocks, I suppose it doesn't actually look too bad. It actually looks kind of awesome, right? It's got a little bit of modern art vibes going on over here. I think that looks pretty sweet. Let's get all of this jazz packed in here. There we go. All of these little wedges. There's hundreds of them in here, man. Such a crazy, crazy build. But it just turns out so sweet, you know. It's one of the things I really love about modded is that, I mean, an episode of this, of modded, takes like 4 or 5 times the length of time that it takes for me to record a survival episode. But, you know, there's just another level of achievement that you get from this whole process, I think. And I absolutely love the progress that we make, even though it takes me much longer to actually achieve what I want. I'm just so happy when it actually turns out. I mean, look at this. Isn't this looking amazing, guys? Let me just get a nice little block in there. Look at that. I actually really like how they turned out, the stripes. I think they look kind of cool. Look at that. Oh man, that is so epic. And what we need to do over here though is probably complete the floor level. So these are going to have to become carpenter's blocks. And yes, I know I am not being the most efficient person right now when it comes to using these blocks. A lot of you guys have been pointing out that I'm wasting blocks, so to speak. But you know what? We have got a ton of carpenter's blocks actually, and it's not too bad. The wastage isn't too bad. And we have so much netherrack right now. Nether quartz, excuse me, that it doesn't actually matter that much if we waste a bit of it. We're kind of rich right now. You know, I've been doing a lot of off-camera mining and gathering, so... but, you know, I do want to try and preserve blocks where I can, because it will compound in the end, right? So in this situation, I think we'll probably do that and then lift it up like this. And then let's fill in these carpenter's blocks just with stone, because we'll never see those. And then we can top it off with the floor over there. So that is absolutely epic. Look at that, man. Oh, that is so cool. Okay, nice. Oh, man, I'm loving that. So we are going to be replicating this kind of tunneling system all the way through the Cyber Labs. What we're going to have to do is now work out exactly how the tunnel is going to travel all the way through this passageway. It's going to be kind of tricky, I think. But we'll figure it out. And of course, we're going to have some sort of a pod, a hibernation pod down here where our bed will be and our bedroom will be. So it's turning out a freaking sweet, man. Now, I started today's episode here in the brand new machine room of the Cyber Labs, right? Shall we just call this place the Cyber Labs from now on? Let's just call this place the Cyber Labs. Because let's face it, this is pretty much the Cyber Labs 2.0. And, you know, I really miss the Cyber Labs. And for those of you guys who don't know what I'm talking about, I actually played a modded series before that was Feed the Beast Minecraft 1.4.7. And I had a build in that world that was made inside of a village. And it was basically, it was called the Cyber Laboratory. The Cyber Labs is what it was called. So I've missed that place so much. And I kind of want to relive those glory days and remake them Cyber Labs. So that's what I'm going to do. I want to start off in the machine room over here, guys. And I want to try a little something something with you while I've got you. I want to try and just spice this place up a little bit. You guys can see that I've just installed a whole bunch of random machines that I need every now and then. These are actually alloy furnaces that you guys haven't seen before. Really easy to make an alloy furnace, actually. If we just pull it up over here, all you need is a bricks that are made out of clay. So that is kind of easy to make. And an alloy furnace creates a whole bunch of different ingots that we are going to need throughout the series. So I thought to myself, let's get a couple of alloyed ferni up as fast as possible. Now check it out. I want to just improve the overall look of the machine room over here, just using these wedges. Instead of having these square shelves, why don't we have wedged shelves like this? And check it out, these wedges actually do act smartly, which is pretty cool, if you can actually get them in there. Let's have a look here. Boom, there we go. You can see that one acted smartly. That one did not act smartly, which is kind of annoying, but let's try again. There we go, looking good, all connected. And that one's all connected too, so that's looking awesome. And I'm thinking, because these are machines, right, they need a lot of air. They need a lot of ventilation, right? So why don't we make a few of these laboratory blocks that have these ventilation vents in them and get those under there? Oh yeah, baby, that is awesome. Let's get that in here, man. We'll get this texture going underneath these machines. There we go. Maybe we don't do it throughout all of them. Maybe just under the ones that need it. Oh man, that looks so awesome. There we go. Oh yeah, that's what I'm talking about. Now, the way that I have set up this machine room, my friends, is pretty simple. What I have done, actually, you know what? These will be solid blocks, I think, underneath these iron chests. So I've connected all of these different machines. We've got the alloy smelter, a pulverizer, some redstone ferni, these alloy furnaces. I've connected them to the power grid with these leadstone flux ducts. And then I've connected all of the machines into a piping network. This is a separate piping network to the overall Cyber Labs piping network that delivers the items we create here into these chests. And it's been pretty helpful, actually, because, you know, sometimes I just need to smelt down something without sticking it into the actual system itself. And that's where I'm doing it over here. And I have been creating these red alloy ingots. And I'm going to explain to you guys exactly why I've been making these. It's because I want to make myself some red alloy wire. And to make red alloy wire, we need three red alloyed ingots. And a red alloy ingot is made out of redstone and a bit of iron. So a super, super cheap recipe to make these red alloy wires. But, my friends, I am going to amaze those of you who have never played modded Minecraft before. I want to show you a little something something that's going to make you extremely happy. Let's make some of this red alloyed wire. Now, red alloyed wire essentially acts like redstone dust, right? So it's basically exactly the same. Do I have some redstone dust around here? No, let me just show you guys. This is just so cool. It's one of my favorite things in modded Minecraft is red alloy wire. I know that sounds kind of weird and kind of geeky, but I geek out every single time I use red alloy wire because it is that awesome. So you know your traditional red redstone dust cabling goes something like this, right? Yeah, yeah, you know, redstone cable, there we go. We can send a redstone signal through this cable. But of course, when we get to a wall, there's a problem, right? We can't get this redstone dust to go up a wall. Mojang, please, can you actually make that a thing? That would be absolutely amazing. But check it out. With red alloy wire, you can actually send your redstone signals up walls, around corners, up onto the roof. Look how sweet that is. Absolutely amazing. I am just, the biggest fan of this cabling, guys. It is absolutely amazing. It is basically, for me in modded Minecraft, it is the quintessential cabling mechanism that you can use. Now, there's a whole bunch of different varieties of redstone cables that you can create too. Essentially, you can create ones that have jackets around them, so you can put rubber around them and all of that sort of thing. And of course, what that does is it means that they disconnect from each other, so you can make a whole bunch of different circuits and whatnot. You can get pretty complicated with this cabling, which is pretty cool. Let's just stick a vent in there, just because. But for today, my friends, we are going to be using this redstone cabling to try and figure out exactly how these sliding doors are going to work. And I think, in my brain, I know how to make this work, but only time will tell. I'm going to sleep the night away, my friends, and then we're going to get cracking on this sucker. My favorite part of modded Minecraft has arrived. It's time to get technical in the new Cyber Labs entrance. Oh man, this is going to be so sweet, guys. I'm going to try and do this all on camera. I'm not sure if I'm going to be able to pull it off. I might have to make a few cuts here and there to get it right, my friends. But I'm going to do my absolute best to nail this in one go. And the reason that I think I can do this... Oh no. Okay, we already got problems. The reason that I think I can do this in one shot is because I made very similar doors to this in my original Feed the Beast series. So I'm hoping that I can remember. Now, I was working a little bit on this last night, and what I quickly noticed, as you guys can see over here, is that the door I'm trying to make is conflicting with the wedges and the walls of the pulverization facility down there. So basically what it's meant is I think I'm going to have to push everything out. I'm going to have to put this airlock docking system all the way out here into the meteor entrance. But I think that's going to be okay. I think we can make it work. We need a little bit of space, of course, to do all of this redstone cabling. Now, what I want to do, let me try and essentially set this up for you guys as a mock-up, okay? So what I'm trying to do here is to make a Star Trek door, right? That's probably the best way that I can describe it. Let's get some sticky pistons over here. No, again, I've done this completely wrong. So let's push these sticky pistons one block back. Man, I always do this with the sticky pistons. I always put them one block too forward. And essentially what I want these doors to do is to automatically open when we approach them, right? And to create a really cool sound, like a kind of sound. And I think pistons already make that sound in a really cool way. So I'm happy with the piston noise. And essentially what I want to be doing is creating a door that is going to open and close when we stand on some pressure plates. Now, the door itself has to be always closed, right? That's probably going to be the first thing that we need to figure out how to do. And that is when this redstone cabling is going to kick in. So let's get a redstone torch out. We're going to trigger the bottom piston by sticking a redstone torch on the back of that piston or behind the piston, right? So there we go. That's triggering that one. Now, we can place some red alloy wire onto these pistons, or we should be able to. Okay, we can't do that anymore for some reason, but I think we can probably do it like this. Let's have a look. Yeah, there we go. Okay, so the red alloy wire is going to connect into the pistons that way. Now, what we have done is triggered all of the pistons at the same time. So, for example, if we take the torch away, you'll see that the pistons trigger at the same time. If we stick the redstone torch in again, they open at the same time. So, that's going to be a really clever way for us to open and close our doors. Now, we got a little bit of a problem over here because we've broken this wedge. Let's get back down in here and try and do a little bit of repair work. Let's hope this acts smartly. No, it doesn't. So, we're going to have to hammer this thing into place. There we go. Get that textured up. Okay, there we go. Nice. And now we can get back out here. And I hope that we will be able to place some red alloy wire on top of that one. Let's have a look. Okay, so let's get the redstone torch over here. Place some alloy wire. And yes, we can stick the alloy wire there. Or we can stick the redstone torch there. Okay, so there we go. Now we've got our first door that has triggered shut, right? Everything is closed. Of course, what we would have to do is put another section behind there to make sure that it's airtight. So we would have to have another wall running like this. And on this side, right? Okay, looking good, looking good. Now, what we have to do is install a second door a little bit further on. And we're going to have to work on some sort of a ramp or something over here, right? It's starting to look a little bit janktastic. But we'll be able to figure out. Let's get the foundations in first. And then we can try and figure out how we're going to do the rest of it. Let's just make a bunch more laboratory blocks. And I think I've got some more sticky pistons in here. Yep, I've got another set of sticky pistons over here. So we're going to have to make this like so. Mm-hmm. One more on top there. Just finish off the floor. And another little pillar over here that is going to hold those sticky pistons like that. And let's get the second set of doors in. This is probably not enough space over here, though. We probably want like two or three blocks in between, right? Okay, so we're going to have to go even further. Although, we might be able to do it in here, right? We might be able to set up a door in here. Huh. Okay, let me see if I can get that done. I've done a little bit of snooping in and amongst this blockage over here, and I think we might be able to get this done. One of the challenges is, of course, these wedge blocks, which make up the roof of the pulverization facility. And what we essentially need to do is to be able to power these pistons, right? We need to be able to get a redstone signal into all three of them at the same time. And that was one of the things that I was a little bit worried about. But check it out. I have a feeling that if we can get some redstone signal into the wedge will be able to power this bottom block. So we may not be able to put the redstone torch underneath for the inside door, but I think we may be able to do something like this, right? So if we did that, hang on. So if we put our redstone torch like that, yes, that opens all three of them. Okay, that's awesome. Now, I don't have to damage the roof of the pulverization facility, so that keeps that intact. That's absolutely amazing. Now, we can do exactly the same on this side. We can install our doors or our sticky pistons on this side too, which is absolutely awesome. And it's going to be on this wall, like a so. There we go. Let's just get behind them. And that is facing the wrong freaking way. There we go. And on this side of things, we can do it the same way as we did on the outside, by sticking our redstone torch on the bottom sticky piston and then red alloy wiring the top two. Okay, there we go. Nice. Now, that is looking pretty cool. So we've got our two doors going on here. I think that maybe this space might still be a little bit tight, right? This space over here. So maybe what we do is we move the outside door one this way just to give us a little bit more room in here, and we could create quite a nice decontamination chamber inside here, right? Yes, that's exactly what it'll be, a freaking decontamination chamber, baby. Oh man, this is turning out so awesome. Take a look at this, guys. I just noticed that the Cyber Labs build is starting to show itself on the map. Check it out, man. The white blocks of the storage facility are sort of digging their way out into the terrain, and we can see the entrance starting to take shape over here. That's kind of cool, but I do think we're going to have to do a bit of terraforming over here. Actually, a few of you guys mentioned in the comments of the previous episode that we're going to have to take care of this at some point. Yes, it is looking pretty ugly around here, isn't it, man? We are absolutely destroying the environment around here. Look at this. It's looking so janky. Yeah, we're going to have to do some terraforming over here to fix this. We cannot have our beautiful landscape looking like that, man. That's looking terrible. Anyway, I think I have pretty much figured out exactly how I want this to be. Check it out. Just using a couple more different laboratory blocks for this. I used the small steel tiles over here just to try and differentiate the entrance here, or the decontamination section of our little airlock over here, right? And I've got the pistons working, looking pretty awesome, and all we need to do now is pretty much finish off all of the walls of the place. So maybe what we could do is do this together. Let's get all of the walls in, and yeah, I'm gonna have to try and think about how we're gonna do this rampage over here. It's looking particularly ugly, I must say. And let's just get a few more of these in over here. Actually, these are not turning out too great. Let's get a few more laboratory blocks down, and we're going to have to fix up the entrance. And of course, we're going to be using some of the wedges here too. Now, I wonder, we're probably going to have to do something like this, right? Because we don't want any air coming through the actual pistons themselves. So we're going to have to block off the air like this when the pistons are fully extended. So that's going to look kind of janky, I think. But we can probably make it look kind of cool with a little bit of this action. Check it out. Here's what I'm thinking. Let's get some of those wedges out. And if we stick a wedge below and above, like that, and like that, okay, there we go. And then what we can do is turn, oh yes, here we go. This is going to be pretty cool. We can turn these blocks into the decontamination vents, right? So these are going to go and squirt some sort of decontamination juice all over, yes. And we probably want to turn those into that also. Oh, dang it, that doesn't work. So these are okay, I think, for now. But yeah, that's looking pretty cool, right? That's looking pretty cool. Let's just get this sorted out. Freaking chisel. Okay, so that's looking pretty cool like that. Now, let's get more carpenter's blocks for the roof. So let's finish off the roof section, like a so. And, oh, we might be able to add some more ventage up here. Okay, so this is going to be... No, that's not going to work either, I think. So we'll just have these as the lights. Okay, so there we go, just like that. That's looking pretty cool. Now, we kind of need some doors, right? We might be able to use... Man, these laboratory blocks are just... They're just so dark as doors. I wanted to try use these ones. But I think that these are probably going to be a little bit ugly if we get these in like this. Yeah, those aren't the greatest looking doors, I must say. Not 100% mad about that look. But I'll try and find something a little bit better. For now, let's just use these ones to represent the actual sliding doors. So there we go. Get those in place. No, that is cute, but 100% incorrect. Okay, let's get those in there. Looking good. Now, let's finish off our little wedges over here, like this. And just one more laboratory block into this one. A boom. Okay, so this is the decon chamber, right? Looking kind of cool. Maybe what we can do is make the roof the same as the floor. So we'll make it these laboratory blocks. I'm sure there must be some chisel blocks that'll work better here. There we go. So that feels a little bit like a decontamination chamber. I think we could probably do better, actually. Maybe we make these wedges into the ventilation blocks also, right? That could be pretty cool. Let's try that out. So let's get some wedge action back into these positions like so. And then let's chisel up these vents because we know that we can use the vents in the wedges, right? So let's do a little bit of that action. Yeah, that's looking pretty cool. Now, okay, now I'm thinking I don't really like the way that these look, right? A little bit too square. So why don't we try and get a little bit of crazy? Let's try and see if there is a wedge that will fit in to the top, into the middle, and into the bottom. Something like that, right? Here's what I'm thinking. Where is our hammer? There it is. Now, let's try change the top and the bottom one into something that might fit. Oh, that is so close. Actually, nope, that doesn't quite work, does it? Okay, let's see if we can find another one. There we go. That kind of works, right? That's starting to look half decent, I think. Check it out, man. I've got all of these wedges in here now, and we can pretty much create for ourselves a super decontamination thing over here, right? It really does feel like when you walk in here, you are blasted with air and whatnot. The only problem that I have with this is this area over here, these wedges that are sort of cut. I don't know, man. I just don't think it's feeling very good. We could probably fix these up like this to complete the look along the top, but we won't be able to do it on the bottom over here, which is a little bit unfortunate. Oh, man, I'm going to have to do a little bit more experimenting with this, though, my friends. But I think the airlock is starting to come along pretty nicely, actually. It's starting to look pretty cool. Almost exactly how I imagined it, really. The only thing that we need to work out now is exactly how we're going to open and close these doors. Once we come in here, of course, we want to be able to hit or this door to open once we have opened this one. So I think what we could probably do now is experiment with using a few pressure plates over here. and see if we can actually get these doors to trigger. Now, this is going to be involving a little bit more cabling, and essentially what we are trying to do, if we break it down, is we want to send a redstone signal into this block over here, right? And I think we could probably do that in quite a smart way by using some of this redstone or red alloy wire. So what we could probably do is let's try and set up a couple of pressure plates over here. Okay, so if we whip out this, let's just start off with wooden pressure plates, right? Let's just start with wooden pressure plates and see how they work out. So let's make a couple of wooden pressure plates and let's just say that this is going to be the location where you trigger the entrance into the door, right? So we've just returned from the cyber labs from an expedition to collect some biological materials for evaluation, and we want to now come into the cyber labs. We're going to hit these pressure plates. These doors need to open, so they need to go tsh, and then we need to walk in here. These need to close, and then these need to open so that we can then walk into the cyber labs. So that is the configuration that we are going to try and work out how to do right now. So let's try to figure it out, okay? This should be pretty straightforward to do. What we can do here is use some of this red alloy wire like this. Okay, so that's going to be triggering the redstone signal. We can send that redstone signal backwards like this, and I think, oh, actually this might be as simple as this, right? Let's get the redstone the red alloy wire now going into this block. Now, I wonder, is this going to trigger these pistons? Let's throw something on the pressure plate. Yes, it does. Okay, fantastic. So the pressure plate has triggered the redstone signal, turning off this torch and thus contracting this set of sticky pistons. Now all we need to do is replicate that exact system on this side. So let's get the redstone cabling running along like, oops. Redstone cabling? Why do I keep calling it redstone cabling? Red alloy wire, ReNDoG. Freaking ReNDoG brain. See, this is what happens when you record a video directly after coming home from work, my friends. A brain doesn't quite work as it should, but let's check it out. Is this going to do the trick? No, that didn't do the trick, so I must have broken something somewhere. Actually, this might be the problem over here. It might be because... Oh, okay. I see what's happening. I think this redstone... Let's have a look. Let's throw... Okay, there we go. That seemed to do the trick. Interesting. How come that didn't trigger when I stood on it? Okay, it looks like it's doing some sort of weird dual trigger action going on in here. And it's definitely not triggering that one. I don't think I've wired it up properly, actually. Yeah, I haven't gotten this one wired up properly. I think... Yep, there we go. That's the one that needs to open over there, right? I don't think that's going to fix the conflict, but let's check it out. No, that definitely doesn't fix the conflict at all. In fact, that's absolutely terrible. Okay, let me try and figure this out, guys. I'll be back with you in a second. Right, so I did that completely 100% wrong. Yeah, it took me a while to figure it out, guys, but I think I've got it, okay? Let me try and break it down for you what I've done over here. By the way, I've just replaced these blocks over here with another laboratory block just to make the place look a little bit easier to work with. This is where we are currently using redstone and stuff, so I just wanted to make it a little bit more clean so we're not placing redstone on stone and all of that sort of thing. But let me try and break it down what we're doing over here, guys. What I've decided to do is try and use a single redstone torch to power all of the sticky pistons. Okay, my theory is that if we've got a single redstone torch powering all six pistons, when we turn that redstone torch off, it's going to trigger all of the pistons at the same time, and there isn't going to be a sort of conflict of redstone signal interest, if that makes sense. So what I think I'm going to try and do is run a separate circuit coming from our pressure plate up here, and I've changed the pressure plate from wood to stone because the stone pressure plate has a much quicker signal. The wooden pressure plate has a sort of delayed or sustained signal, and I want the signal to be really, really quick. I want it to just be a quick zap of redstone, or of signal anyway. And here's what I'm thinking, right? So this is where the pressure plates are sitting, on these two places, and I reckon if we run this red alloy cabling down underneath like so, and then into the block that's touching the redstone, the redstone torch isn't going to trigger that block, but But if we hit this pressure plate now, what we should see is all of the doors retracting at exactly the same time. Let's just get a little bit of this action going on like this. Let's check it out. Bam! Okay, that works absolutely perfectly. That's exactly how I wanted it to work out. Okay, let's get another stone pressure plate in here. Just make sure that there's no conflict, even if I stand on them both at the same time. That's looking awesome. Look at that. It's opening absolutely perfectly at exactly the same time, perfectly in sync, and that's exactly how I wanted it to be, man. That is absolutely epic. Let's just hide the shame of these pistons like so. So there we go, man. That is the entrance into the Cyber Labs. Hitting these pressure plates opens the door, which brings us into here. And of course, the next step is going to be to try and figure out how to trigger the next set of doors. Let's just get it all opened up so that we can see what we're working with. And essentially what we are going to need to do is get that redstone signal that we already have going over there, which I just freaking broke like a noob. Oh my goodness, absolutely ridiculous. Let's just get that cabling rewired over there. So essentially what we want to do is send this signal that is coming from that redstone torch into the other doors, I suppose. But I guess what we need, we could do it another way, right? We could send the signal that's coming from our pressure plates via a separate circuit into the second set of doors. And what we could do is probably stick in a repeater into that process, and that's going to delay the signal that's coming from the piston into the second set of doors. So that might actually be the way to do this. And I'm thinking we might need to do another little clever bit of red alloy wiring over here. Let's maybe do it on this side, right? So if we bring this red alloy wire like so, okay, and then down below this cabling, so it's got to go one block underneath this cabling so that it misses it completely. Okay, there we go, that is perfect. Let's just get it like that, and it's going to go all the way like this, right? Oh my goodness, I'm going to run out of redstone cabling, aren't I? Dang it. Okay, so here are the doors, right? There's the piston that we need to trigger. We know that there is a redstone torch on this block, I believe it is. Let's just dig our way out on this side without breaking anything too important. Yeah, so there's the redstone torch that we need to turn off, essentially. This side is a lot more complicated, though, of course, because the redstone torch is above everything, right? Oh my goodness, guys, this is going to be tricky to figure out. I'm gonna need a moment off camera, okay? Well, CyberDogs, I think it's safe to say that I have had something of an epiphany. I've spent the last 20 minutes or so trying to work out how we're going to do this. Of course, the trouble that I am having is trying to find a way to get the redstone signal to trigger the second set of sticky pistons. And the real trouble is that this set of sticky pistons is very close to the wall of the pulverization chamber, and it's really hard for me to get a cable behind there underneath. Because of course I then have to bust into the pulverization chamber, which you can see is right over here. However, I have had a stroke of genius. Instead of sending this redstone signal underneath the door or underneath the sticky pistons, why don't we send it over the top of the sticky pistons? Pretty obvious, I know, right? But guys, that's modded for you, man. You got to try and figure out the simplest solutions to some of the most tricky problems. So here we go. Here are our pressure plates up here. These are the pressure plate blocks. They are sending a redstone signal into this redstone torch, which is currently powering these sticky pistons. Now, the next step for me is to try and make sure I can get a redstone signal into the second set of sticky pistons. These sticky pistons are obviously powered by their own individual torches, so I don't know if the synchronization is going to be there, but let's try and do one thing at a time, okay? So here's what we're going to do. We're going to run our red alloy wire up and over the top of the sticky pistons, right? So I think this is going to work out quite nicely. I've laid out the foundations for how I want this cabling to go. It's going to go over the top like this, and then it's going to go over here, and now that is going to be turning off that redstone torch when that redstone signal comes from the repeater, right? So far, so good. Now all we got to do is continue this redstone signal all the way over to the other redstone torch, which is sitting somewhere over here Yep, there it is over here. Okay, so we need to get that cabling into this position over here. So let's just take away all of this stuff just to make sure we can see what we are working with. I think we're probably going to have to go up and over. Yeah, so we'll go up and over like this, over the carpenter's blocks, down again, and it looks like we'll have to go over one more block like this. Yes, perfect. And that's going to go onto that redstone torch like that. Okay, fantastic. Now, hopefully, when we hit that pressure plate, we should see both of our sticky piston sets triggering, right? So let's hit the sticky piston there. That's triggered. And it looks like that actually did trigger. Yes, that did trigger. But, of course, we haven't set a delay on our repeater here. So let's set the delay to 4 and have a look if that's going to help to create the delay that we're looking for. Of course, what we want to do is the first set of doors to open before the second set of doors, right? And we want the first set of doors to actually close behind us first. Okay, there we go. We can see that it is working, but it's triggering a little bit too fast, and we have some synchronization issues. So I'm thinking we probably have the same setup that we do on the first set of doors, where a single redstone torch is powering the two set of pistons of the back doors. Okay, this is turning out pretty good. It's starting to work out now, guys. Let me see if I can get the setup complete, and I'll bring you back in a second. I think I cracked it, guys. Oh man, this is going to be so epic. I actually think that this is going to work out. I was a little bit worried there that I wasn't going to be able to make this work in today's episode, but I have surprised even myself with my redstoneage today. So check it out. I'm going to be using this redstone torch to power the second set of sticky pistons. We can see that I've stuck a block above the redstone torch, run some red alloy cables along the top of the entrance here, and that is actually triggered all three of these pistons by running the red alloy wire down the blocks next to the sticky pistons. So that is absolutely amazing. Now we've got a single torch powering these two sets of sticky pistons, which means they are now completely in sync. Now, if we hit the pressure plates, we should see the first set of doors opening up and then the second set of doors opening up, all in a beautiful unison. Let's actually get some blocks down so we can see this happen, okay? Let's just get the doors in place like this. Dang it. I'm gonna trigger them. Okay, no, there we go. I didn't trigger it. I don't wanna trigger it just yet, okay? I wanna see it happen in full freaking action. Okay, let's get the blocks like this. Now, this should work out beautifully, right? We're gonna hit these pressure plates. The first set of signals is going to trigger the sticky pistons or de-trigger them, and then the second signal is going to go over the top and trigger the second set of sticky pistons at the back there. So let's do this. Bam, first door opens, and then second door, dang it, what is wrong? Did I do that wrong? I think I might have broken something over here. Okay, let's try that one more time. That should have worked. I did hear a double set of piston triggers there, so that is kind of strange. Okay, we open, trigger, that opens, and then it closes again. Okay, dang it. I'm gonna have to troubleshoot. I think I done broke something. Derp. the signal was actually disconnected, and the signal going to the second set of sticky pistons was not actually happening. So that is my bad. Here we go. This should do it now, my friends. Let's check it out. First door opens, second door opens. Perfect. But it doesn't look completely synced up, actually. Okay, that's looking a little bit strange. I am on a troubleshooting roll right now, my friends. I figured it out. Check it out. This redstone cable was installed previously as an attempt to turn off the redstone torch that was powering this set of sticky pistons. But of course, that is no longer required because both sets of sticky pistons in the second door are being powered by a single redstone torch, which of course is in this position over here. So we don't need the second cable, which I think is creating a bit of a problem because it's re-triggering everything again once the redstone signal has reached the pistons via those repeaters down there. So that should actually do it now, my friends. I do believe that has done the trick. Oh, say it ain't so. I think I just nailed it, guys. Did you see that? Did you bastards see that? Oh, baby, let's give this a try. Let's give this a try here, okay? Let's finish off the doors. Let's stick all of the door textures or the temporary door textures in for now. Close this sucker up because we know that redstone signal is working. And let's get outside. I'm not going to look. I'm just going to assume it's working. Okay, there we go. Let's install the doors again. Now, the way that this should work is that when we hit this pressure plate, this door should open. Then the signal will be delayed by the repeaters, and then the second set of sticky pistons should open, thus opening the second set of doors. But we should be enclosed inside of that decontamination chamber first. So let's do this thing, guys. Hit the pressure plate. We go inside. Door closes. Second door opens. Oh, and I didn't get out in time. Dang it. Okay, I might have to add a repeater or something to that secondary circuit over there. But I think that this is working out, right? We could actually probably run just straight through if we're quick, right? Second opens and we're in, baby. Oh, that is epic. That is actually working. I'm quite speechless. Yeah. Still a little bit of tweakage to do, though, just to get all of the synchronizations and whatnot sorted. But I'm going to do that off camera, guys, because it's been about an hour and 40 minutes now working with this door. But I'm loving how it's turning out, guys. Really hope you enjoyed today's episode. Lots of technical jazz going on. And I do hope you like the way that the cyber labs are turning out. I'm absolutely loving it. This has been ReNDoG playing modded Minecraft Survival Stories 3. If you enjoyed the episode, hit that like button. If you haven't subscribed yet, I don't know what you're doing, but if you don't hit that subscribe button, I'ma shove a sticky piston straight up your ass. Yeah, I went there. It's gonna happen. Thanks for watching, my friends. We will see you in the next episode.